In this video, I want to share with you how to get and use Microsoft Publisher on your PC. It's available also on the phone, but for this tutorial, we are going to concentrate on how to use it on the PC. So the first is you can get it by coming to office.com. So to those who don't know much about Microsoft Publisher, it's an application that helps you with your design of your pages and layout. It can help you to design flyers, templates, and different kind of business cards and all that. You can easily use it to market your products and services around. So to get it, you have to come to Microsoft Office. Okay, you get to office.com, for example. Once you're here, you can come to Get Office, and you can see the pricing and how to get Microsoft Publisher. So the first thing you need to do is to come back to your PC and launch Microsoft Publisher. So you can come to your start menu over here and just search for Publisher. Okay, and you can see it over here, Publisher app. Just click on it to open. Once you open it, you see yourself at the home tab. Okay, and over here there at the home tab, you have a bunch of things to look out for. For example you can start a blank page on A4 portrait, or you can start a blank page on a landscape, or you can have a landscape, but you can check out for more page sizes, so you can resize or you can customize your page size accordingly. And then over here you have a bunch of most popular templates that you can use from Microsoft Publisher, and you can easily use them to design your flyers or anything. Okay, down here you have the option to check out the most recent publisher document that you have used, or you can even pin the document, or if you have multiple documents open, you can easily use this search icon to search for them. You can see more templates by clicking on more templates, and you can see a bunch of them. For example, over here you can see a bunch of them. You can use anyone. Maybe your baby is having a birthday and you want to use something to celebrate that baby. You can put a picture and use this to celebrate, or your mom is celebrating her birthday. You can customize this and change the age, and maybe change the coloration and other content as well. You can equally do suggested searches based on personal, based on design, set, labels, events, paper, business cards, and all that. Okay, so you can feel free to try it and see what you can do. And down here you can open an existing or already published or already opened already created Microsoft Publisher document. But for this tutorial for today, we are going to start on a very fresh blank page, so we'll go with A4 size, and it's going to be a blank page, so we just click to kickstart it. Now this brings us to a very fresh and blank page of Microsoft Publisher. You can see the looks, it kind of looks exactly like the way we have our Microsoft Word. So what is actually the difference between Microsoft Word and Publisher? You see, Publisher actually deals with design and layout, and Microsoft Word deals with text compositions and all that, text editing features and all that. But Publisher is specifically professionally designed for people who want to market products, who want to create flyers, posters, cards, and many more. Okay, so let's try to have a look at it. When you look at Microsoft Word, I think the looks kind of look similar and nearly the same. So, but there's so much to look out for in Microsoft Publisher. So for example, this is a blank Microsoft Publisher page, but we don't want to start on a very fresh blank page. Let's say we want to design something simple that has to do with public speaking, and we don't want to design it this blank page, white blank page. We want to put in a page background. So the first thing we need to do is to come to page design. Okay, so you have a bunch of things, you can check out the bunch of things, but in page design you have a lot of things. For example, you can change this template to another template, we can have change the margin, orientation, paper size, and guides, and many more. Okay, so we can change anything that we want to change from here, but for this tutorial we want to change the background. So we just click on background, and we can see a bunch of no background if we want to remove, and we have solid backgrounds and we have gradient background. But for this tutorial we want to design something kind of little bit attractive that's not so common, so we're going to go on more background. Okay, and we can see a bunch of things that we can do. We can say no fill, a solid fill, gradient fill, and we have a picture or texture fill. So let's go with picture and texture fill, and we can say insert. And when we click on insert, we have a bunch of things to insert from a file. If you have a file from your computer, you can navigate and search it. And if you have a stock images from online, we have stock images. Usually Office 365 comes with stock images, so you are free to go online and search for these stock images or online pictures, or you can bring in icons from the search collections. Okay, so let's say we'll go with stock images, and over here you can search for icons, cut out people and stickers, and then you can have illustrations. But let's say we want to stay at the images over here, and you can just search for something. Okay, so we set something like speech or something. We just want to show some illustrations of maybe speech or someone speaking, something like that. So maybe we can choose anyone because the images are kind of quite good in terms of the resolution. So we can maybe take on this, or let's say we go with this, and we can click on insert. We can say okay at this point, and you can see the image has just popped out, showcasing public speaking and something like that. You can see the arrangement quite nice. So the next thing is I want to put in some picture. Okay, some other picture. From maybe I can come to the home tab, I can come to insert, and I want to put an online picture. So maybe I want to pick microphone. I want to search for microphone. Let's say I see microphone, different kind of microphone of different size. So be sure to check out this Creative Commons license. Okay, if you check this, it means you will not have any problem with any image as regards copyright and stuff. But if you don't check, definitely you are going to have problem. Okay, so just make sure you have it checked off so that you can have only copyright free images to use. Okay, so let's say we are clicking on any one of them. So let's say we want to make it transparent. Okay, transparent, so that it cannot fit on our image without actually creating any form of distraction. So let's say we go with this, and then we'll click on insert. So right now we can kind of move it around. When we look at it, you can move it and it will snap to any point when compared to Microsoft Word. Okay, this is one of the difference. In Microsoft Word, you cannot move images like this to any location of your choice. So but for now, let's say we are taking it up here, and we are kind of resizing it to a little bit, reduce it a little bit. Okay, so you can see this. But the next thing is, I think we're good with the images. We can bring in some text, so we can come to the home tab. So at this point I want to insert something that can make this flyer kind of looks cool. So I want to insert a page part, maybe a quote or something. So we come over here and we can come to insert, and we can come to page parts over here, and we can see a bunch of different things that you can insert. Maybe you can go with a simple quote, maybe here pull out a quote, and you can just maybe take from here. So let's say we're going with this, and you can see it. Okay, so let's write down a piece of code. Okay, so this is a very popular code. They may forget what you told them, but they will never forget how you make them feel. So try to select, and maybe let's say we want to increase the size, decrease a little. We can see it over here. So they may forget what you told them, but you never forget how you make them feel. So let's say this is a quote, and we want to bring in something that could signify our company. So we can just come over to the home page, or you can come to the insert and come to draw a text box, and maybe you can draw it at the bottom here. Before we put in the text box, at this point we can put in a shape. So we can bring in a shape. For example, we'll take this shape, and we can just come over here and just click and drag and have it connected over here. So we can just resize it accordingly, and we can resize accordingly also to fit in. So over here we can double click to have the shape format selected, and we can change the coloration. For example, right now we can make it to slightly darker. I think we can notice we have some black shapes around, black color around the shape. So we can double click and say shape fill, shape outline. We can say no outline, and I think that kind of looks cool. So we can insert the text. So let's click on our draw, and then we can bring it over here, and we can make it, we can type our text over here. We can select, and we can increase the sizes, we can increase the text box size as well. Okay, we can bring it like this, and we can select the text and change the coloration. I think to white color will make it kind of, I think changing the color to white can make it kind of cool, and maybe we could bold it. I think it's okay at this point. So you can see our flyer, it's kind of looks good. So you can just share this with your people, and you can easily have them understand your message, and maybe something about your message. Whatever business you have, whatever idea, whatever concept you want to share with your people, you can easily design your flyer easily and customize it to your liking. So once you're done, one key feature I want to highlight here for Microsoft Publisher that makes it quite different with Microsoft Word is that we have the guide over here, and you can easily bring them to help you work accordingly as you work. So for example, you come to these rulers over here, you can just easily drag and you can notice them. You can notice a green line, a green thin line coming in, and it can help you to divide your flyer or your page accordingly. So you can see, for example, I drop one here and you can see it clearly, and you can drop one also at from the bottom. You can just drag and move in, and you can see it coming up, and you can use it to drop or to subdivide the guide, the flyer easily, so it can help you to design very easily. So it's a very cool feature, but when you print, nobody will see this. It's just for your own guide. You can put more than one. You can put multiple if you want, both horizontal and vertical. You could put multiple of this guide. It's called guide. You can make use of it, and it will help you to navigate and to paste in your content accordingly. Okay, so this is about it. And once you're done, you're satisfied with the content and you're satisfied with what you've designed, you can always come over here and come to the file, and you can save your document. For example, you can browse and you can have it saved in a given location. So let's say we want to save it here, and we can just give it pub 1. Okay, we can save it. All right, now we have saved this as our document. Okay, additionally, you can come back to the file menu and you can come all the way. You can create a new page, you can open an existing one, and you can check out the print option. You can print, you can select your printer, and you can see the preview of how it's going to look. You can select the printer and you can check other features, other options as well, and you can print easily. Alternatively, you can share through an email, send the current page through an email as attachment, as a PDF or as an XPS format. You can easily send this, and you can email the preview directly to someone that you are working with. Additionally, you can come down here and you can create a PDF document or an XPS document from this. You can just click this create, and it is going to create it for you. And you can publish this as a HTML page. You can easily publish it, and you have a link to share with your friends very easily. You can publish it online, and you can change the file type at this point to different kind of file types. Right now it's set to .pub, which is the publisher type, and you can change it to PNG, JPEG, and other features, GIF, and many more. So TIFF, you're free to check on any kind of file format, and you can save it from there. Other file types are the .html, which is a web page, and you can save as another type, just select from it. And you can save this for printing, which will preserve the resolutions and many more, and you can save it for commercial printing. Also, the resolution is going to be quite interesting, so you can use it for commercial printing, and you can print directly from here. And you can save for another computer. If you have a computer, you can pick and you can save it from. So this is just a bit on how to use the Microsoft Publisher to design your template, to design your pages, to design your cards very easily. Like I said, the major difference is that this is design and layout centered, or like the Microsoft Word, which is text composition centered. So some few things that I would like to highlight from here is for you to take note of is it's at the insert menu, you have what you call the catalog. When you have come to your catalog, you can insert pages to start your catalog. You can insert different kind of pages to let you merge multiple records from data source into a single publication. You can insert different kind of things from here. So make sure you use these page parts accordingly very nicely. There are a bunch of things that you can use to beautify your content very nicely. They are very, very interesting parts that you can easily use. Additionally, you can have this advertisement, which you can use to pull out flyers and attention getters, so you can advertise maybe your course, and you can easily use this to market off or to show off the promos that are going on to help people easily subscribe or register in your content. One last thing, you have business information over here. You can write your business information easily using these various formats. You can easily just write your business information according to the format within just a single click. You can just insert your logo over here or something. You can just click to insert your logo maybe at the bottom over here, so people can easily see to register. Think on the page design, you can check out the master pages, so you can play around with master pages and check around what you can do. You can edit master pages and bring in different kind of features also if you want. And on the mailing list, you can use mail match on this if you have you can use to send in multiple pictures or multiple emails within one click to different kind of people at the same time. Okay, I've made a video on how to use Mail Merge, but I think it's a very important and cool feature that you should look out for in Microsoft Publisher. It can help you to have a better, very fantastic experience with your content. There are a bunch of other things that you can enable once you start using Publisher, and many more. So feel free to try it, register if you have to, and download it and start include it on your desktop. You can always pin it if you want to pin. Okay, you can, if you use it quite often, you can pin it to the taskbar and you can use it consistently. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, this is about Microsoft Publisher. If you enjoyed this video, please remember to give it a thumbs up and don't forget to hit the subscribe and notification buttons to stay connected to this channel for more of our very, very useful videos. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.